हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सुनील गोठीवाल, कंसल्टेंट डर्मेटोलॉजिस्ट, स्किनिवा क्लिनिक जयपुर। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी विल टॉक अबाउट बेसिक इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट मिलाज्मा। मिलाज्मा इज कॉमन एंड रिकरिंग स्किन कंडीशन इन विच वी हैव डार्क ब्राउन पैचेज ऑन फेस, समटाइम्स ऑन फोरआर्म्स। इट इज मोर कॉमन इन फीमेल कंपेयर टू मेल, एंड इन फीमेल ऑल्सो इट इज कॉमनली डेवलप इन डार्क स्किन वुमेन इन एज ऑफ 28 टू 38 ईयर्स। And most of the female develop this melasma during pregnancy or after pregnancy. That's why we call it mask of pregnancy. So when we talk about basic problem, what happen in melasma, that there is overproduction of melanin. So there is not a single cause that is causing overproduction of this pigmentation in the skin. There are multiple triggering factors. So out of those, important three triggering factors are ultraviolet rays exposure, hormonal factor. Among hormonal factor, we have female may have disturbance of hormones because of pregnancy, oral contraceptive pills or hormonal replacement therapy. The third important factor is family history. Among minor triggering factors, presence of other autoimmune disease like thyroid, stress, on and off change in cosmetic products, and prolonged iron deficiency or presence of anemia, or some medications which can make your skin sensitized to sunlight like anticonvulsants. These are minor factors. In male specifically, sometimes this disease is associated with low testosterone hormone levels. When we talk about symptoms of melasma, it can present in three forms, three types. It may be superficial, we call it epidermal melasma. It can be in deeper layers of skin, we call it dermal melasma. And sometimes it is mixed type, present in both the layers. So why it is important to identify the depth of the pigmentation? Because the response of the treatment will depend on the presence of pigmentation. So deeper pigmentations are resistant to treatment and require combination approach. And epidermal melasma are easier to treat with medical treatment. When we talk about sites, people know that melasma is most commonly present on face. On face also, cheek, nose and forehead are the most common sites. And sometimes female may have melasma on upper lips or jawline. Then in a few female, especially in postmenopausal, the melasma can present on extrafacial or non-facial sites like forearm, arm, or sometimes on ear pinna or sides of the neck. Can also be involved. Dermatologist, during when you visit the doctor, dermatologist check for type of color you have in your melasma. It is light brown, dark brown or grayish brown. Based on these colors, dermatologist decide that the depth of the melasma. And sometimes he can use some tools like Wood's lamp examination or dermoscopy to check the depth of the pigmentation. Otherwise, melasma doesn't require any specific test. In some scenarios, when history is giving some indication about iron deficiency or thyroid or poor response to past treatment, then we can advise some test for these factors, like a complete hemogram to check hemoglobin levels, iron profile and thyroid profile. When we talk about treatment, there are three major concerns by majority of patients. They ask that, is it possible to cure melasma, or if it is possible, will it come again on my skin after stopping the treatment? And if it is coming again, then why should I take treatment? These are the three common queries. So I want to tell in very clear words through this video, and you must know this also. Yes, treatment is possible. It is possible, very much possible, to clear the melasma, but there are higher chances of recurrence after stopping the treatment. In fact, you can say it recurs in 50 to 60% of patients. But the grading of recurrence will vary from patient to patient. In some patient it will be 5-10%, in some 50%, or in rarely in some patients it can be total, whole 100% can come again. The third query is, why should we take treatment if it is not going permanently after medications? See, melasma is very totally harmless skin condition. It is not going to affect you and in any other way. It is just a cosmetic concern. Especially in female, it affects psychologically also. So patients who are having melasma and affected cosmetically or psychologically because of melasma, they should take treatment because treatment will clear your melasma. Maybe it is 70% or 80% or some 50%, but it will reduce your burden of pigmentation. And because of this pigmentation, what psychological impact you are having in your life, it will improve definitely. So it improves quality of life. So their treatment is indicated. So when we talk about treatment options, so there are medical treatment and procedural treatment. So in medical treatment, first is sunscreen. It is backbone of melasma treatment. So whatever treatment you take for melasma, either creams, peels, laser, or oral treatments, or oral tablets, or injections, or whatever, you will need sunscreen all the time. And it is the component of treatment that will be continued after your complete resolution of melasma. It will doctor will not stop this sunscreen. Most of the time, dermatologist suggest sunscreen beyond SPF beyond 30. It should be broad spectrum. Physical sunscreens are preferred over chemical sunscreens. So, and applications should be repeated at least 3 to 4 times in day. Sunscreen should be repeated in every second or third hour. Suppose if your outdoor activity is starting around 8 to 9 a.m. in morning, so you have to apply sunscreen 15 to 20 minutes before your outing, and then every third hour you need to reapply it. If you are staying most of the time in indoor, then you can reduce the frequency, but it is not like that. If you are staying in indoor, then you do not need to apply sunscreen. It is not like that. Now on skin lightening creams, or you can say melasma clearing creams. So there are 3 or 4 types of categories. In first category, that is most popular, it contains hydroquinone. Hydroquinone is a bleaching agent. It comes in different concentrations, and doctor decides according to depth or color of the melasma, according to your skin type, the percentage of hydroquinone will be decided by doctor. And second category is fixed combinations of hydroquinone, tretinoin, and one steroid. These are the called triple combinations. So there are two variants. In one steroid will be mometasone. In other one, the steroid will be lesser potent steroid. So these mometasone-based triple combinations are older preparations and are out of trend now. But on most of the occasions, patients get this mometasone-based triple combination from chemist on over-the-counter basis. And this mometasone is very harmful for skin, so you should not use either hydroquinone cream or this triple combination creams on your own. You should always start these creams on recommendation of dermatologist, because the percentage of hydroquinone and selection between only hydroquinone or triple combination and the duration of the cream will be decided by doctor after seeing your melasma. Third type of creams are non-hydroquinone, non-steroidal creams. So these are for over-the-counter use. You kojic acid based creams are these, and they contain other components also, like arbutin, liquorice extract, vitamin E, glycolic acid, vitamin C, and mandelic acid, many other. It can be cocktail of all the chemical herbal things. You do not need to ask your doctor or some prescription to apply these creams. So you can start on your own, because there is very lesser chances of any side effect with these creams. If you have applied in a good amount or for good duration and your melasma is not responding, then you should visit your doctor. So these are the creams. This third type of preparation are mainly for maintenance purpose. Whenever you start, follow your treatment regularly with according to doctor. He will change the intensity of skin lightening creams. He may start with lower, then he may increase the potency of creams, or sometimes if things are favorable, then he may directly start from powerful skin lightening creams and then gradually taper the intensity of cream. Sometimes oral tablets are also given by a doctor. In oral tablets, you can have tablets which work through blood factors to clear your melasma pigmentation. And sometimes minerals and antioxidants to protect your skin from sun. This is extra to topical sunscreen. This is not replacement of topical sunscreen. And third one is glutathione. That is nowadays in trend for skin lightening or skin whitening purpose. Sometimes doctor can use injections of these tablets also. Glutathione or tranexamic acid can be used in injection form for melasma treatment. So what we expect from medical treatment? There are three or four scenarios. Few percentage of patients will respond nicely. The melasma will go with medical treatment and doctor will be able to stop your active treatment and patient will be continued on sunscreen or on and off skin lightening creams of third category. Majority of patients have clearance of melasma with the treatment, but when doctor start tapering or stopping the medicines one by one, some percentage of melasma reappear. In third scenario, that patient is not responding adequately, there is 50% 60% response with medical treatment and remaining melasma or pigmentation is not going. When these two scenarios are there, when melasma is coming again or it not cleared completely with medical treatment, we need some combination of procedural treatment. We add other treatment modality. For these modalities, procedures like chemical peel or laser toning, the third indication is if sometimes patient need faster clearance or faster results because of some event or wedding and any other thing, this treatment option can also be added. In procedural treatments, two most popular things, chemical peels and lasers. The chemical peels are the chemicals composed of one or two or three agents. The agents are same, glycolic acid or kojic acid or TCA or mandelic acid, but they will be present in higher concentration. These peels come in different variations, different combinations. Percentage concentration varies from brand to brand, and the formulation also, some comes in gel form, some lotion form. These factors affect its efficacy, the results of peel. So doctor decide according to need, patient's skin type or remaining melasma or type of melasma, color and affordability. So these peels will be applied on your skin in clinic by doctor and it will be removed immediately in time period of 1 minute to 10 to 15 minutes depending on peel. So after 4-5 days you will start exfoliating your skin. Your skin will peel off gradually and end of 7 days or 10 days or 15 days you will start noticing changes. In laser toning, it is Q-switch NDIAG laser which is used in melasma laser facial, and this laser will break down your pigmentation in a skin and that breakdown pigment will clear with help of blood. In laser toning, you will notice some changes just immediately after a laser facial, and some changes come after 5 to 10 days. In both the treatment, chemical peels or laser toning, you will need repetitive sessions to maintain the response, and after 4, 5, or 6 sessions you will be put on maintenance sessions. When initially they are repeated on gap of 20 days or 25 days or 1 month, then later gap can be increased according to need. So these are the treatment options. And last, I want to tell some tips to get maximum of your treatment for melasma. So limit your outdoor activity. Try to avoid outdoor activity between 10 to 4 because these are the peak hours for ultraviolet rays if you are having melasma. And always carry your sun protection kit, which should include sunscreen, a good sunscreen, and some umbrella or a scarf or hat or goggles, and you should always wear them whenever you are going out, because protecting your skin from sunlight will stop progression of disease as well as it will help to maintain the response of treatment. Third one is you need to check your triggering factors. If you are taking hormonal pills and hormonal therapy on and off, then it can affect the result also. So you should discuss with your dermatologist as well as gynecologist if you are taking some kind of hormonal treatment. You should strictly follow with your dermatologist, because in follow-up visits, most of the time dermatologist change the prescription, because these hydroquinone creams or triple combination creams cannot be continued for longer time. And sometimes it happens that patient comes in first visit and then he visit after 2 months or 3 months and he or she continues to apply those creams. So they can be harmful in that scenario. So you need to follow up regularly. So active treatment takes 4 to 5 months. and after that majority of patients are on maintenance treatment and require less frequent visits to doctor. Another tip is about healthy lifestyle, stress management and dietary factors. Good diet rich in antioxidants, vitamin E, vitamin C can help your melasma also. So in the end, to summarize, melasma is common, harmless, cosmetically affecting skin condition. If you need treatment, always follow your dermatologist regularly, strictly. Sun protection is the key. Try to identify triggering factors. If there is any triggering factor is present, try to resolve by discussion with dermatologist or your other treating physicians. It have successful treatment options available, but recurrence is problem, so you should understand that. And cosmetic procedures are for those who want faster clearance or are having poor response with medical treatment. We will provide further detailed information about procedural treatments in separate videos for chemical peels and laser toning, and we will also provide you information on problems created by these OTC skin lightening creams in separate video. I hope with this I will be able to convey basic information about disease, triggering factors and treatment options, and it will help you in managing your skin problem. If you like this video, please share with your friends and subscribe our channel for further videos. Thank you.